Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday Morning and the Old Cookbook Show. Today we're going to do a recipe out of this cookbook, published in 1898, and it is called the 20th Century Cook Book. And this cookbook is filled right to the top with lots of recipes, lots of thoroughly modern recipes, lots of thoroughly modern recipes for the late 1890s and the coming 1900s. The recipe we're going to do today is called Shrimps a la Newburg, and it's right underneath Lobster a la Newburg, and you prepare it as the Lobster a la Newburg. And so the method and the instructions are essentially the same as Lobster a la Newburg, although I will have to change a couple of things. Now, at the beginning of the book, there is this little bit of boasting. Mistakes are hardly possible, so explicit are the directions given. And I believe in 2021 parlance, I should be saying, hold my beer, and we'll see how that goes. Now, the recipe starts out with shrimp, and these are shrimp that I have peeled, deveined, and pulled the tails off, and they are raw. Now, the instructions, of course, are for lobster, and with lobsters, you would need to kill and boil and cook the lobster completely. And a lobster takes a lot longer to cook than shrimp. So I'm not going to boil the shrimp ahead of time. I'm just going to put them into the pan. They will cook through this entire process, and I don't want them to overcook and become rubbery. So into this pan, I'm going to put butter the size of a walnut, and I'm just going to melt that a little bit. Actually, that was butter the size of an egg, but egg, walnut, same thing. Now, I'm going to put in the shrimp. I'm going to season with salt and a pinch of paprika. Stir that together. Now, I'm supposed to let this cook for 5 minutes, and I'm expecting fully that at the end of that 5 minutes, the shrimp will be pretty much fully cooked at that point. Next, I'm supposed to put in some sherry or Madeira. So, I've got some sherry here, and I'm supposed to mix a tablespoon of sugar into the sherry. So, and measure that out, put the sugar in, and let the sugar dissolve. Okay, in goes the sugar. And we'll just give that a bit of a stir. So at the end of 5 minutes, the shrimp are pretty much cooked all the way through. They're nice and pink. Now I'm going to pour in the glass of sherry, which is about a half a cup. I took away most of what I had poured into the cup. And there you go, with the sugar as well. And the sugar does not fully dissolve in that sherry. Now, I'm supposed to let this boil for 3 minutes, so I might turn the heat up just a touch. Meanwhile, I need to whisk those 3 egg yolks with a cup of, what do they say? 1 cupful sweet cream. So hopefully I've got a cup here. Almost, like 7/8 of a cup. Okay. There we go. Okay, just whisk those together. So this is one of those recipes that pops up not too long before this cookbook is written. The first reference to this recipe is sometime in the 1870s at Delmonico's in New York City. And it's called Lobster's Wenberg, after the name of the person who invented it. Although the chef at Delmonico had to take that invention and make it into a decent recipe that could be served. Shows up on the menu, Lobster Wenberg. There's a falling out, there's a big fight. Wenberg demands that the recipe be taken off, or the dish be taken off of the menu. Delmonico says, yeah, sure. Lobsters a la Wenberg, gone. Lobsters a la Newburg shows up. So they changed the name, but they didn't really change the recipe. And the first time the recipe seems to appear in print in a book is in 1894. So just a few years before this cookbook comes out. And there are a lot in this time period of variations on the recipe, depending on where it's seen. And there can be cognac, sherry, Madeira, as the alcohol. Cayenne or paprika can be the flavoring, and shrimp is as popular as lobster. So I'm now supposed to let this boil for 5 minutes longer, and I'm sure the cream will reduce and the egg will set. Hey, Jules.
Hi, Glen. Hey, friends.
So this
That's
is
really yellow.
This is shrimp a la Newburg, which is the variation on lobster a la Newburg, one recipe up.
Okay.
So before we get going,
okay,
I want to
thank we get going.
I want to thank the viewer that sent this book to us. Thank you very much.
Yes.
I love it when books arrive, especially ones from this time period. They're fantastic.
It is true. He's like, we gotta go.
Gotta go. Gotta go to the post office. Okay.
What makes it so yellow? What's in it?
I don't know how I feel about that.
Is there a lot of butter in that?
No.
Like, what gives it that creamy texture?
Cream.
Oh, just straight up cream.
Cream. So there's butter the size of an egg.
Okay.
And then a cup of cream, and there's sherry.
Mmm.
Now.
That's what gives it the sweet smell.
That's why I was confused
with the butter. It's the sherry smell.
The sherry. And you don't really taste the sherry. It just adds a background layer.
There isn't something specific that's making it yellow then?
No, it just boiled it down.
It just is. Okay.
Oh, egg yolks. There's egg yolks.
Oh, yeah. That was.
It's like I just made it. I can't remember what's in it. Now, here's the thing. As I just told you, this is Lobsters a la Newburg with this great story of how it was invented and the whole deal. There's a competing dish called Lobster Thermador.
Yes.
That crops up at the same time in France. So this shows up in New York. The other one shows up in France. They share 75% of their ingredients. Their method differs a little bit. And this is actually closer to Thermidor than Newburg, if that makes any sense. So if you can, take a look at two versions of this of the recipe, the Newburg and the Thermidor, and see how they, you know, how they overlap and how kind of tricky it is to tease out where a recipe came from.
Yeah, no kidding. It's always a mystery.
But I think this would be great over pasta.
Yeah, it's quite sweet, though. I would actually throw it with some greens of some sort, like a spinach or a any kind of green you like, kale, if that's what you like.
Put it over grits with collards or
yeah. Yeah, I think the sweet and that earthy flavor
Swiss
of greens. Yeah, Swiss char would be really good.
This Swiss char and grits. Okay, thanks for stopping by. See you again soon. Yeah, one more.